Hi children, this is your physics Vinay sir. So as for your information, and all of you know, now the classes are going on DD Adigiri and TSAT in Telugu medium. That's why it is a little bit difficult for English medium students. For them only, I am going to explain these same worksheets in English. So watch, go through them. After these, we'll meet in live classes. Go ahead. Hi children, this is yours physics sir, Vinay sir. I think that this is our first class. It's very sad to me actually. So because of corona situations, we are going through online. But it is the time to actually share live class. So anyhow, this is the only option for us in this panic situation. Okay children, some of you asked me, please explain the worksheets in English medium because you are not able to understand the remaining classes in TSAT and DD Adigiri. Okay, for that only I am explaining this, so watch it. Children, now this is the worksheet 1. This is now worksheet 1. The chapter name is Matter Around Us and topic was classification of materials. So here first you have to know about the what is matter. So here matter is nothing but object that should be having certain mass and that can occupy some volume also. The substance or object which is having certain mass and thus should be occupy some place when we can keep anywhere. So that is called matter. So here the matter is nothing but, for example, now you are sitting in your class or in home and just you are watching my video. Just you can look at your surroundings. What are they? For example, if you are in a room, you can find some chairs, electric bulbs, television, and some water bottles, bags, stabilizers, sound boxes, like that. If you are nearer to the kitchen, your mother is watching some vegetables. So here all these are objects. They are also having some mass and they also occupy some volume. Clear? That's why here the matter is nothing but the substance which has certain mass that should be occupy some volume. That is the matter. Now here you have to know about how the matter can be classified in how many forms, on which basis they can be classified. You have to know that. Clear? And for that, there is one simple activity is mentioned in that worksheet. Children, look here now. Matter. What you are telling is, look here. Anything in the universe which has some mass and occupies some space is called, that is the matter. He was given some examples. Look there once, table, chair, blackboard, food, and water, cloths. So all these are examples for matter. And here the matter is made up of tiny particles, very very small particles. And now here, based on the arrangement of the particles in matter, the attractive forces between the particles, the matter exists in different physical states. Just before I told you, what's that? How the matter can be classified. What you are saying now here, based on the arrangement of particles in the matter and attractive forces between the particles. Based upon these two properties, one thing is what? arrangement of particles, how they are arranged, and attractive forces. According to Newton, if any particles have certain mass, they should be attracts each other. So based upon that, attractive nature between the particles, and next thing is what? Arrangement of the particles in the substance. Based on that, the matter can be divided into three types. They are solids, liquids, and gases. Dear children, the matter is classified into how many types? Three types. What are they? Solids, liquids, and gases. Okay, these three states should be explained with one activity. Simply here, what you are saying, collect one stone, glass of water, and incense stick. Collect stone, glass of water, and incense stick. Clear? So all these are available at our home. So for example, here we are taking one stone that should be kept over a table, and beside that we are taking some tumbler or any vessel, in that we can pour some water. Clear? And after that we are taking some one incense stand, there we kept some incense sticks. Clear? And after that, with the help of the matchstick, we can light that incense sticks. They can burn. So while the incense sticks are burned, what do you observe? Some fumes, smoke, little bit smoke should be spreads throughout the room. So here we are getting the smell, but we are not able to see what's happening there. Okay, so what do you have, children? Three things. One is stone, next one is water, and next one is incense sticks. For example, I am asking you, go and touch the stone. Then what do you say? It is the stone. How you are feeling now? It is lightweight or hard? How you are feeling means, then automatically what you can say? It is very hard. And I suggest you, one more student, and go there and put your finger in the water tumbler. Then what you can observe? The finger is easily going into the water. It does not obstruct your finger because the water is very thin. And third one is what I am telling, incense sticks. While they are burning the incense sticks, here the smoke is spread throughout the house. At one place only we are lighting the sticks, but what we observe, the smoke is occupies the everywhere in the house. So here, what is the reason why the stone is very hot, and why the water is very low, becomes thin, and why the smoke, the gases are easily spreads? The reason is that in solids, the particles are closely packed. If we can fold our fingers completely, then it becomes very strong. When fingers are separate, we can have some weak forces like that. When in case of a solid, all the particles are closely packed, almost all closely packed, there is no gap between the particles, that's why they have more attractive forces. Children, clear? Due to that attractive force only, the solids are very strong in nature. And next bit, what it is? Water. In case of water, it's very clear. If you can pour water in different type of containers, they will attain the different shapes of the containers. Here water can occupy the volume, it has some mass. That's why it is matter. Why there is no particular shape for the water? Why? Because here the molecules in the water, they are little bit separated. In case of solids, the particles are very close together. There is no gap between the particles. That's why solids have more rigidity, and they can occupy the equal volume if you can keep anywhere. Got children? That's why here solids have particular shape and volume. But in case of water, there is only volume, and the shape is not fixed. Clear, children? In case of gases, at one place in our home we can lighting the incense stick, but that should be occupies the entire volume. That means in gases the molecules are very 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 far away from each other. That's why they have less attractive force. That's why there is no particular shape and no particular volume for gases. So this is the main difference between solids, gases and liquids. Clear, children? So it was given same thing here. Look at now here, activity 1. What you are saying? Place the incense stick with matchstick carefully. When the spark is lit, you will notice that the gases are released from the incense stick. Now touch the stone and touch the water and smoke coming from the incense stick. What you observe? What you are saying? Spark is lit. You will notice that gases are released from the incense stick. All of you know. And now touch the stone, water and the smoke coming from the incense stick. So what you observe? You will feel the stone is hot and the water is thin and does not seem to hold the smoke coming from the incense stick. What you are saying? Stone is hot, water is thin, and it is unable to catch the smoke coming from the incense stick. Clear? So what is the reason for this? Means what is the reason for that? Simply, in case of solids, they are very close to each other and the arrangement is regular. All are arranged in a regular manner, like a rose. Clear? And in case of water, lot of small distance between the molecules of the liquid. And next thing is what? Gases, already told you what's that. In gases, the molecules are separated by more distances. Clear, Nana? So this is about the solids, liquids and gases. And now here, another example was given, activity 2. Collect a few pieces of ice at your home, take them into a vessel, light the gas and put the vessel on the flame. All of you know that, for example, in our home, some refrigerator is there. Already know that in deep freeze what you have, some ice cubes are there. So you have to take the ice cubes from the fridge and keep in a bowl, and that bowl should be placed on a gas stove. Here, initially, what you observe, I am saying ice cube. After heating slowly, what you observe? The ice cube is slowly changed into water. And again, you are heating that one continuously. What you observe? Again, the water is changes into vapor. The same water should be changed into one state to the another state. So he was telling, look here. Heat the vessel continuously for some more time. What you have been observed, you will notice that water from surfaces gets converted into the vapor. So what you learn from this activity? So look here, you will notice that there exists in three physical states, because ice contains water, water contains vapor, vapor also contains water. So this is based upon these three, activity 1, activity 2, you must be come to the conclusion. What's that? Matter means, matter is nothing but the substance which have certain mass and that should be occupies the volume. And next thing is what? The matter is divided into three types: solids, liquids and gases. In solids, the particles are closely packed and they should be arranged in regular manner and they can occupy the same volume at any place. Clear? For example, if you are taking a a book. That should be placed in different places in your room. And measure the dimensions. How much volume should be occupied by the book. That must be always same. Because it is a solid. Clear? And next thing is what? In case of water, liquid. The molecules are separated by some distances. That's why they have no particular shape. But they have particular volume. Because if you can pour water in different containers, they will get the different shapes. But volume is same. And now in case of gases, the molecules are separated by four distances. The gases are invisible to us. Because they have no particular shape, no particular volume. Clear? This is the children, the main difference between solids, liquids and gases. So now we go for next slide. So look here, Nana. So classification. Properties, it was clearly mentioned. Look here. Based on the physical state, the matter is classified into three types: solids, liquids, and gases. So clearly mentioned there, definition and arrangement of particles. First, I am going to explain solid. The substance in which the particles are arranged very close to each other in a systematic manner is called solid. I already explained you. Closely packed or very close to each other particles, and they are arranged in regular manner. Examples are what given. You know all is well. Stick, coal, stone, sand, sugar, salt, book, pencil, etc. So nobody knows. And now liquids. The substance in which the particles are arranged with the intermediate distance and in irregular manner called liquids. In case of solids, the particles are arranged regularly. The same thing will be repeated. But in case of molecules, not like that. Liquids. Okay, clear? Intermediate distance. That means what? Distance is not less, not more than. Distance is more than the solids and lesser than the gases. Examples, every day you are taking the water, milk, tea, and you are using the kerosene. And you know about the blood, petrol, cough syrup, alcohol, etc. So here all are visible. Here, look here. Liquids. Clearly mentioned in the diagrams. And now gases. The substances in which the particles are arranged very apart from each other and completely irregular manner called gases. Told you already. The gaps between the molecules are very, very, very high. So examples are air, smoke, water, vapor, nitrogen, oxygen. Clear children? So this is about the solids and liquids, gases. So now here assessment work is given. Clear Nana? Children, here look here. Substances are given below, identify and classify them the solids, liquids and gases. So we have to do this one. Here they given sugar, petrol, oxygen, honey, salt, carbon dioxide, ghee, book, ink, aroma of mu, sponge, charcoal. So based upon your knowledge, you have to classify them. Now you got idea about solids and liquids and gases, that's why you have to do this one. And here all other here. Is there any similarity in all materials? You have to find this one. So you have some questions here. So you have to prepare that. You have to answer them. Clear? So this is about the first worksheet what you are watching in the DD and TD set. Okay children, thank you all. We will meet in the next worksheet. Thank you.